This week at the Internet Cafe, love and romance on the web. This is Global Match, a free dating service online. Meet Midori. She offers advice to the lovelorn in cyberspace. It's called Bianca's Smut Shack, but it's really a PG-rated chat room that gets a million hits a day. And meet Nina Rage. She runs Divanet, where you can buy the most outrageous romantic fashions. Plus, we'll show you how to keep your young kids away from some of these sites. And free software that will let you travel to a cyber utopia to meet cool people. And the romance test for finding out if love's your thing. All coming up on our Cyber Blast, Love and Romance on the Web, this week at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is made possible in part by Intel. One innovative idea always leads to another. Now there are connected CD-ROMs that link rich multimedia with related information on the Internet. The connected CD-ROMs with the Intel Pentium processor.
Hi, and welcome to the Internet Cafe. I'm Stewart Cheifet here with Jane Wither and Andrew deVries, a little bit under the weather.
Yes, I have my orange juice here.
Yeah, that vitamin C. Yeah, you sound a little sick.
Yeah.
You were in New York, and that's.
I went to Internet World. Yeah. It's probably the biggest Internet show of the year. They had 50,000 people.
Probably the biggest Internet show ever.
I think so. It was huge, and it was very exciting. There was a lot of cool technology.
So what was the newest, neatest stuff that Internet
I think World? the push technology, the technology that is now allowing people to not have to go out and search the web for information they want, but actually have it brought right to them when they want it, when they want to check on
great.
It. Yeah, and a lot of the news companies especially are very excited about this because it's a way for newspapers and things to deliver custom content right to your desktop. And also, I partied a lot. I went to
and
a
you
lot
got sick
of great, great parties, and
no
that's
surprise.
Why I got
anything
sick.
About romance or
well,
dating on
I went to a lot of parties, and there was a
real
lot of,
thing. It was the old-fashioned way.
Eligible young women there, but unfortunately, I think I need to go back to the net because.
All right, Jane, we're talking about romance on the net. You have any personal experience with sort of cyber dating?
Well, none personally, but
okay.
I've actually had a friend of mine
suspicious.
A friend of mine,
yeah.
Who got recently divorced, and so she got her subscription to America Online and started into some chat rooms and actually started dating online,
and finally
she met the man, and they started dating for about 6 months,
yeah.
And things didn't work out,
but it was a pretty good
experience.
Okay.
I mean, she got somebody who had shared the same interests, and it was pretty interesting, so.
All right, dating and romance on the net, tonight at the Internet Cafe.
So, Midori, you write an advice column about sexuality online. You also work for San Francisco Sex Information. What's that all about?
San Francisco Sex Information is a free, anonymous phone switchboard, and they are a resource for answering any questions or giving referrals about human sexuality.
So anything goes, pretty much. You can ask any questions you need to get answers to.
Right.
So that leads me to asking you a question, which is about sexuality or dating online. And basically what that's all about. And I think there's different rules of engagement, I know, you know, dating online, but what are the different forums?
Okay, different places where you can meet people, whether you're dating or just looking to meet. You have the large organizations such as America Online, CompuServe, and other services, where it's national and as well as global. So you may be meeting somebody all across the globe, and you can have real-time chat rooms there, or you can also go more locally and have BBSs or bulletin board services where you would post messages where people would read at their leisure.
Okay.
Or real-time chat locally.
So I can have ongoing conversations.
That's correct.
Live.
That's
now,
correct.
You know, when I think about online dating, the first thing I thought about were, you know, the video dating services where you get the videotape and you say what you're interested in, they match you up. Are there services like that as well?
Yes, there are. And those are by subscription, obviously.
So, yeah, there must be different rules in online dating or, you know, just meeting people rather than, you know, blind dates or meeting a friend of a friend at a party, those types of things. What are the rules?
Actually, I'm glad you mentioned that because we are at an era where we have discovered a new means of meeting other people. And we have to relearn our dating skills and relearn and establish a whole new sense of ritual about romance and dating online.
How so?
Well, for example, you need to make your intentions known very clearly because there are some people that are going to be online strictly for online fantasy.
As opposed to wanting to meet you ultimately and those types of things.
Right, and there are other people that are on there looking for somebody to meet in real life, and this is just simply a nice introduction. So a person needs to be clear hi, you know, I'm so-and-so, and I'm just here for fantasy. And you may see me several times, but this is all I do. I'm sorry, I'm not going to meet you in the real world. Or, hello, I'm Joe, and I'm looking for somebody that I can connect with in real life. Can we talk?
So that leads me to some questions. I mean, one of the things can change over time. Obviously, once you start chatting, you get to know
yes.
somebody, your intentions can change.
Yes.
So it is important to make sure that you continually are clear about what your intentions are and if
Absolutely.
They change. Because that really runs into the issue of safety
yes.
on the net. I know there's some cases of you know people who are starting to have these fantasies on the net with people, and they you know things can go awry when they actually meet one another. I mean, are there things that you can do to protect yourself from getting into a dangerous situation?
Well, I want to point out one thing, that dating is risky.
Period.
Whether it's real life or online. Here you are getting acquainted and becoming emotionally intimate or physically intimate or conversationally intimate, take your pick, with somebody that you really don't know. And whether you're dating in the real life and going to a movie with somebody and on a date, or if you're talking online and decide to meet them for real, you're taking risks. So the dangers
are similar.
Yeah.
So that's definitely one of the issues. And I think the other big thing that I think a lot of people are concerned about is children getting access
right.
to the internet. And not knowing if you're dealing with an adult
mm-hmm.
when you're having a conversation online and you start dating. Are there things that you can do to identify whether or not you're talking to an adult or not?
Well, first of all, you have filters for children, obviously. If you're a parent, it's your responsibility to put in filters and to educate your child. But let's say I'm online dating or talking with somebody and I'm not exactly sure how old this person is. You know what I'm going to say? I'm talking to you. I'm going to say, where were you when John Lennon died?
Good one, exactly.
Yeah.
To start asking some leading questions.
Right. Or if you're a little older, you may say, well, you know, where were you when Kennedy died?
Right. So that's a great idea
mm-hmm.
as well. There's lots of different things that you can do to make
mm-hmm.
sure that you're being safe.
Hi, my name's Julie. What's your name?
My name's Spike.
Hey, Spike. What do you look like?
I have long black hair and dark eyes.
What do you do in your spare time?
I like to go for long walks in the park.
Ooh, that's sweet. Want to go for a walk with me sometime?
Sure, good looking.
Because in cyberspace, no one knows you're a dog.
So, John, you are a real matchmaker, not just a cyber guy, but I mean, this is your business. So,
right.
How do you become an expert at bringing people together?
Well, I started a company called John Michael Introductions about 3.5 years ago, and I have an office out of San Francisco. I've been working throughout the Bay Area. And actually, how you become an expert is not like a college for matchmakers or credentials, but I feel I love people. I value romance. A lot of people say education is one of the most important things in life, and I think that is.
And you
true.
Were a single guy looking...
I've been single. I know what it's like
to
go out and
right.
try to find somebody special, not just find a bunch of girls to dance around with and have fun.
Yeah. Now, what's different about the cyber dating business, about running this thing online like you do with Global Match?
Online is a completely different thing. Unlike Global Match, or unlike what I've been doing
yeah.
for personalized matchmaking, people could come online and search through hundreds of files at 2 o'clock in the morning in their robe and email people from around the world, unlimited, and then receive emails back that evening or the next morning. It's unlimited.
Now, do you do automatic matching? Is that if I put my profile in mm-hmm. there, some little engine runs around and finds people, kind of people I'm looking for?
That is being built into the site right now.
Or I can just post it and I can go through it like I would with a newspaper's personal thing and say, oh, I like that one, I like that one.
Right.
And then you contact that person through email.
Right. And what we have what we call anonymous email. So if you went on there and you just create your own name, you want to be Prince Charming or
right.
whatever, you email this woman. She receives it. She might be Ladybug. You get mail back and forth.
And
you don't really know
who the real person is.
You know who the person is to come and see who sent you it
yeah.
by checking their profile.
You don't know their real name.
You don't
or their
have
real
to
address.
Reveal their email,
now,
which makes it safe.
It's safe, but isn't that a little dangerous? Because you got Prince Charming, you got Ladybug. I mean, who knows who you're talking to? They can make up anything they want.
They could make up anything they want, yes. But after you start to email people back and forth, It's new technology, but in a way it's old-fashioned. Write in a letter to somebody.
Uh-huh.
People could pick up get a feel for who you are. We don't recommend giving out your phone number and your real email address on your first contact, but that's totally up to the people.
All right, now what are people looking for? You've done, I know, some studies of the demographics of the people who log on to Global Match. And what are they looking for? Kind of a quick fun or email or somebody to marry?
Well, actually, we right within their profiles, it says if they're looking for email pen pals, activity partners, right on up to marriage partners.
And what do you find?
What I found interesting is over 80% of the men are interested in marriage partners.
They want to get married.
Exactly.
So much for the commitment problem with these guys, huh?
And these are decent gentlemen. Just because they're on the computer these days, the demographics are just all over the place. Yeah. They could be doctors, they could be college students, senior citizens.
Okay, now right now on Global Match, it's text. I put in my profile and I can, it's basically like the newspaper, more or less, right? I can read somebody else's personals. You're thinking of adding multimedia, right? So I can actually hear somebody's voice, see a little video clip.
Absolutely. You'll be able to punch on a little logo, and you can actually see that person speak to you, hear their voice, their tonality, get a flavor for who that person really is.
Now, one thing I've heard when you talk to a lot of people about doing this kind of thing, they say, well, this cyber dating, this online matchmaker stuff is for losers. If you can't get a date anywhere else, you turn to this kind of stuff. Is that, in fact, what goes on here?
No, far from it. I think I've been in this business for quite a while, and the people that come to me, they're far from losers. A lot of them, their income is very high, good-looking people, they take care of themselves. It's just a time issue. And people don't want to spend all week working in the office and on Friday night go out to a club to meet somebody that's not interested in a committed relationship.
So maybe it's just the opposite. These are too busy. These are professional people, as you say. They
Absolutely.
Make a lot of money. They don't have time to deal with all this
Absolutely.
Stuff. All right. Well, let's go check out Global Match here and see what I can find.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Van K. Weller. This is my new novel called Urge to Merge. It's a fictional story about life and love online, but it's based on true life experience. I found out firsthand what can go wrong and right in the strange world of interpersonal cyber connectivity. You don't always know who you're talking to out there, so you have to be careful. But I found that the net can also be a place where our spirits can join, intermingle, and play. Even if you aren't looking for romantic love, we've all got the urge to merge.
So I'm here with Thao in Freeform from Bianca's Smut Shack, which I've heard described as a 24-hour house party. But I also hear it's a good place to meet people people of all different types of persuasions, I guess you could put it. Tell me a little bit about Bianca Smut Shack. What is it?
Okay. Well, the site itself is loosely based on our apartment in Chicago, where a lot of really good things happened. People came in and out and had a lot of good conversation, and some smutty things happened. So we decided to document it and put the whole site up on the web.
So basically, the different rooms in your apartment are like different rooms that you can go into on your site?
Right. Yeah. And so our house, in our apartment in Chicago, was kind of like a flop house. So 24 hours a day, everything was going on. So we thought we'd kind of try and do that on the web, since back then, 94, the web was scientific and educationally based.
The Vatican was the raciest thing on the web at that time.
Right.
So out comes Bianca Smut Shack.
Right. So have you guys been on since 1994?
Yep. Mm-hmm. February 94.
One of the first 500 sites.
How many hits are you getting a day now on your site?
We get about 1.5 million hits.
1.5 million?
Right. From 50,000 unique visitors.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's amazing. So tell me, of these 1.5 million people, when they come to your site, what are they going to find there?
Oh, you name it. Everything. Like in the kitchen, you can talk about cookbooks and recipes, but then you can
now
get
that in. Sounds a little tame to me.
Yeah, very true,
recipes.
Very
this
true.
Is a, we're talking about romance and things here. Yeah. Tonight,
but
so.
Spicier things happen in kitchens.
So you can spice it up a little.
Yeah.
You can have a little
people basically, recipe. Yeah, people talk about whatever they want to talk about, and people often like to talk about smut.
Okay. Right. Especially in, say, the bedroom or the bathroom.
So those are a little bit more of the racier
area. Yeah, a lot more of the racier area.
Okay, now do you find that people are meeting in your rooms here and are connecting outside of the internet too?
Most definitely. That's something that we really, really like about Bianca Shack is that people meet offline. They call them Bianca bashes.
Ah, yeah, so it's like a party.
They've been happening all around the world.
Really?
Yep.
So what goes on at these Bianca bashes?
We have yet to attend one.
You're kidding.
Right.
No, you look like you're ready to in your robe there. Is that what they wear at the Bianca bash?
Soon they will. Once they get a hold of the great outfit, they'll love it. Yeah, I mean, they happen all over the world, and they're self-organized, so we really don't have too much to do with them.
Right.
And they've been in London and Norway and some in Scotland. And there's going to be one in February in San Francisco.
Which we're going to say. I hope you guys are there. Oh, wow. Now, you may need to make everybody sign some kind of disclaimer before they go in, but...
Right, we are safe.
No, so, are there any other stories about people meeting online, getting married, anything like that?
Oh, yeah. There's definitely been a few marriages, a few breakups.
Breakups online, that's kind of a new
Well, you know, like, the husband is at home, he's chatting all day long, and he's chatting supposedly a woman online, and he starts to spend more and more time chatting with this woman, and his wife's like, well, what's going on here? And
So he was jealous, and that ended it.
We've also, we've had some weddings. A couple of people who got married recently have a kid.
Really?
Oh, yeah. And they met, 2 years ago on the shack. This is our first birth.
But your site is definitely for the 18 and over crowd.
Yes,
so.
It is adult nature.
Right.
In fact, most of the people who are on the shack are over 35, I think.
Yeah.
Easily.
Yeah, and they definitely police themselves. When someone underage comes in, they complain a lot to us, or they try to ride them out of the room and say, hey, you're under 18, you really don't belong here, kind of thing.
So. Have you had any problems with things going on online that... suddenly we're taken offline, there's a lot of fear about people, being stalkers or anything like that.
Yeah, we have had a few of that, and that's really unfortunate, but that's just the way
How do you guys deal with that?
Ignore it.
Just ignore it?
Sometimes if it's really heavy and, like, a federal agent calls us up and says, this is slanderous, you must take it off, then we have done that. But we generally don't monitor the site too much. We don't really know what's going on all the time. We can't possibly. It'd take us forever. Right. So only when people actually point things out to us do we do something about it.
Right.
And that happens somewhat regularly.
Well, it definitely does sound like a 24-hour house party with all the good and the bad that comes with that.
Yep. Yeah. So, yep.
Great. Well, thanks, you guys.
Thank you.
On tonight's Cyber Blast, we're going to send you two very cool programs. First of all, a new internet application called OnLive Traveler. Then a do-it-yourself romance test to see how romantic you are. Both programs add up to over 4 megabytes of data, and you'll be getting them both in the next 120 seconds. If you haven't seen these Cyber Blasts before, this is the actual computer data going through the TV signal and right into your computer. I'll explain a little bit later how you can set up your computer to receive the software. First of all, let's tell you what we're downloading to you right now. The first program is called OnLive Traveler. This is an internet application that lets you log on to a website called Utopia. This is a rich 3D world where you can meet all kinds of cool people. The world you enter connects to other spaces where you can go for more private discussions. There's also an online events calendar announcing special happenings in Utopia. OnLive Traveler does require Windows 95 and a Pentium processor in order to handle the 3D environment. Next, we're sending you the romance test from Lovescape. This is a multimedia test that includes telling questions about your attitude toward romance, and it even has a lush music soundtrack for background. Basically, after you take the test, the program will rate you on the romantic scale. 100% means you're the ultimate romantic, 0% means you're a robot or a Vulcan. This file is about 1.5 megabytes. Now, to download these files this fast, you do need something called a TV modem. But if you don't have a TV modem, you can still get these files on our website. Total download time will be a little over half an hour with a 28.8 phone modem. If you need information on how the TV modem works or how to set it up, you can also get that on our website. Just go to pctv.com and click on the Internet Cafe or Cyber Blast buttons. Our download time is just about finished, so good luck with the romance test and have fun at Utopia. That wraps up this Cyber Blast on the Internet Cafe. I'm Laurie Anderson.
All right, Nina, we're talking about romance on the web and that kind of stuff, and you run a site called DivaWeb where you can buy stuff, clothing and tapes and books and pictures and all that. Give me an example of the kinds of things I could buy on DivaWeb.
Well, anything that we consider to be erotic or perhaps of a fetish nature, which is something that people would want to have an obsession or a fantasy about, something that's alternative, unusual, hard to find in your town.
Something that would kind of make you stand out, and people are going to look at you and say, wow, she's different or whatever.
Something more like a corset like this.
Right.
You know, this is...
That's the kind of stuff I can buy on DivaWeb?
This is our Dark Garden corset. It's very unique. It's basically a peplum corset. It's got real steel boning in it. It's a real Victorian recreation. It's extremely comfortable, even though it doesn't look like it, because it's made actually to individually to the congress.
Yeah.
And it sort of tells women that it's okay to have curves.
All right, so you've got
it doesn't look like a 14-year-old boy.
You've got this fashion area is one of the parts of deVries. You've got a model here you brought along.
Yes.
Can we take a look?
Yes, this is a
lot. Would you come in here and let's look at this?
She's consented to our model for. She's our marketing coordinator.
Okay.
This is a
spin around there, Locke.
It's from Wild Designs, and basically this is a peplum jacket, long sleeve, zips up the front with the hugger skirt with the slit at the back that zips down also.
Really nice.
It's very black. It's
well, I don't think you've got to be. You don't have to be a fetishist or anything weird. I mean, that's just a plain darn sexy looking.
Well,
dress,
but I mean, society sort of makes you feel guilty if you look at anything that is like sexual. It's like you know, there's we're not supposed to be sexual, and part of what deVries is about is basically having an adult conversation about, you know, people have these feelings, and it's okay for adults to discuss it, I mean, in a relatively civilized manner without going, you know.
All right, now some people may think this is kind of fringe, but this is a real business. I mean, you're going to sell, what, $1 million worth of stuff on deVries this
year? We've surpassed a lot more than we could ever.
So there's an awful lot of people are interested.
We sell, 75% of our business is international.
Wow.
And I'm talking about Poland, out back in Australia, Norway.
You've got a whole
Africa.
You've got a whole shoe section with boots and heels. What's
ritual
that about?
Shoes and boots, yes. Uh-huh.
How does that fit in?
Ritual shoes and boots is about shoe fetishism. It's about extremely high,
super high heels,
ridiculously, totally unrealistic high heels.
Yeah.
And they're very, however outlandish they can be, spiky, platformy, thigh high, knee high, lace up, buckle up, whatever.
Nina, I got to ask you, part of what goes on deVries Web and part of what you represent is the transgender kind of thing. What role does that play in deVries Web?
For me, it's just something that's there. I was a ballet dancer with the Joffrey Ballet for a long time. I was doing drag in and out as sort of.
You were a male dancer with Joe.
I was a male dancer, yeah. And for fun, I would when I was on layoff, you know, I would do a lot of the drag stuff, and I really enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun. I tore the cartilage in my knee. My career went south in about 5 minutes, and I really didn't have anything to do, so I started doing drag shows.
What's going on now? I mean, with Dennis Rodman and Howard Stern, there's like a whole different feeling about the whole cross-dressing.
It's just I think that you know people can allow themselves to go there and. Chances are pretty good that, you know, they won't tar and feather you and stick in the outside of town, you know, nail you to a tree or something like that.
Yeah. But, I mean, this kind of stuff would be available at deVries Web also.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, the whole gamut. I mean, like patent leather corsets to any latex outfits, latex catsuits, like Catwoman's outfit.
Okay.
Something similar to that. But, I mean, all sorts of combinations.
All right, it's deVries Web.
deVries Web.
Well, Jane, I just found this on the shelf here. I guess it's kind of worth mentioning if you're, you know, doing the romance thing or the dating thing on the web. This is the love relationship test, and there's a bunch of tests you can take here, and it's kind of fun. The intimacy test about sexuality, the love test, find out if you're really romantic and stuff like that. So it's kind of a low-cost program. I thought it'd be fun, but I think you have some more serious issues you want to talk about.
Yeah, I think one of the things, so, you know, we're talking about dating and chat groups and all those types of things, is really for a parent understanding how they need to handle having their children getting access to the internet and some of the things that they need to do.
If you have a 10-year-old, you may not want him or her doing some of the stuff that you're talking about.
And there's some things that you can do. I mean, it's like teaching a child when they go outside to play, don't talk to strangers and, you know, just be careful about the things that you do. Make sure that you've got a friend with you when you do things. It's the same sort of thing on the internet. There's things that you want to make sure that they know about. Things like, you know, when you're on the internet, don't give out personal information.
Don't give out your phone number, your address.
Don't give out anything.
Maybe even your real name.
Yeah, exactly. And some other things, you know, if you're chatting with somebody, make sure that you feel comfortable. If you're in a chat room or a bulletin board, you start chatting with somebody from a different country, for example, another kid perhaps, be comfortable in telling your mom or or your dad or your teacher and about the person you're meeting.
And if that other person says, don't tell your mommy about this, that's probably a warning.
Then you need, that's
right
an
there.
Alarm system to make sure that you are aware of what's going on. Some of the other things, you know, if you get to a website or if you see something or someone that makes you feel uncomfortable, makes you feel strange, make sure you tell your parents about it. Yeah, and be aware of those types of things.
Yeah, and so for parents, there are a couple of programs you can actually buy they should know about that will block out certain websites or control what your kids can do. There's one called Cyber Patrol. There's one called Cyber Sitter. There's one called Rated PG. They all have websites. You can log on and see what they do. And
yeah, you can actually get subscriptions as well monthly, and then they can give you updates on the latest websites that they suggest or recommend that you block out. But the nice thing is you also do want to have some flexibility in controlling it. You may not want to block out all of them.
Sure.
Some of the other nice things that you can do is actually block out words or phrases.
Even in documents that are on your computer.
Exactly, on your own application.
Bottom line, a parent's got to be a parent and pay attention like you would in any other situation.
Yeah.
Well, Andrew's not here. He went home sick. He was really sick.
Not feeling so good. I think he's on the internet looking for chicken soup recipes.
So we're closing it out. We'll see you next week again here at the Internet Cafe.
The Internet Cafe is made possible in part by Intel. One innovative idea always leads to another. Now there are connected CD-ROMs that link rich multimedia with related information on the Internet. The connected CD-ROMs, it's the Intel Pentium processor. Videotapes of the Internet Cafe are available for $24.95 each. To order your copy, call 1-800-916-PCTV. We'll help you stay on top of the rapidly changing world of computers and personal technology. Call today for your copy of this episode of the Internet Cafe or any of our other award-winning programs. When ordering, please ask for tapes by show number and title. That's 1-800-916-PCTV.